Good morning, everyone. Stephen Whiteside here with a look at the North American stock markets for Monday morning. Mondays usually have a bullish bias to them, and the last day of the month usually has a bullish bias to it. So not expecting a lot of downward pressure today. Looking at the futures in the pre-market, stock index futures and commodities are above fair value. So we are expecting to see some buying at the open on Monday morning. Now, Buy, Seller, Hold TV is a new video newsletter that we'll be coming out with, officially launching in January. And we will be opening the site up to new members in January as well. For people who have been on the waiting list, we're going to be sending out a email soon, inviting you to join before the public is allowed to sign up to the site in January. Now, let's take a look at the markets, and it was fairly quiet trading last week with the Thanksgiving holiday, S&P 500 not getting anywhere. We are trying to break out above the recent high and resistance at 21.25. Right now, we're trading above the upper channel. The VIX is trading below the lower channel. The NASDAQ, similar situation for the VIX for the NASDAQ, so no change there. The TSX had a rough day on Friday. That had a lot to do with the price of gold. So a close below Friday's low would give us a new sell signal for the TSX. There's the price of gold breaking support. And we've got some mathematical targets before we hit 1,000. You know, there's a really good chance that the market might want to go down and test 1,000 before heading higher. That's a big round number for the price of gold. Looking at the XAU, it traded lower on Friday, as you would expect, but certainly didn't take out the recent lows. And for the TSX Gold Index, we actually traded up to the upper channel line on Friday, but again, no buy signal, and we did not take out the recent lows. So it's still looking pretty good for these stocks. All we need to do is get the price of gold to start moving higher. Now, Buy, Seller, Hold, Apple Computer, we're currently ranked a 6. We're in the middle of the range here. We're trying to get above the recent high at 123.29. If we can do that, then 125, 130, 125 are our potential targets to the upside. We've gone up and dealt with this open gap here, and now we're starting to trade back. So to sell this stock, you need to see a close on Monday below 116.57. Otherwise, it's a hold on Monday. Looking at Cisco Systems, and the stock has had a couple of open gaps to deal with, and it's dealt with this one, and it's dealt with this one. And so now we're right in the middle of the range here, right in the flypaper channel, no trend at the moment. The pro's not interested in taking control. Our playing field has been between $25, and then we tried to get up to $29.69, couldn't do it. So we're right in the middle, exactly in the middle of that range at the moment. And we're looking for a buy signal on Monday. To generate that buy signal, we need to close above at 27.59. Otherwise, you can stay short Cisco Systems. Microsoft had a big pop a few weeks ago and hasn't seen much more momentum after achieving that big pop. And so the easy money has been made. Now it's hard money. We're trying to get up to 56.25. The pros are still in control, but barely. It looks like most people have taken their profits who have wanted to, and now we're going to see if we get any negative price action. The top of that open gap has acted as support so far, and so if we take out that recent low, then look for a move down to fill this open gap. On Monday, you can remain long or hold this stock until we see a close below $53.31. Next up, we're looking at GE, another stock that had a big pop. We're trying to get to 31.25. If we can take that out, 32.81 is our next target. Pro's still in control on Monday, and we traded down to the lower channel line on Friday. On Monday, we'd get kicked out and generate a sell signal if we saw a close below $30.09 for GE. Next up, we're looking at Sun Edison, and we're down at the bottom of the panic zones. Pressure zone has formed. This is a very ugly stock. You can see when the fan club left the room is right back here. Back here, we were willing to buy the dips. Now people are selling the rips. And so what we're doing is we're making a low, a high, a lower low, lower high, now a lower low. And I don't know if that was a lower high last week. If there is a trade here, then look at that trend line, which comes in contact with those recent lows. That's what the trade is. It is not up to the flypaper channel. This is a very broken stock. We are trading right between the 625 target and the zero target, and this stock has come down pretty hard. That's why you have a zero target. The math on that, you can refine it a bit by just splitting the difference between the two, and you'll find support at the $3.1250, $3 level. I think the low last week was actually $2.90, so that's the area we're looking to find support in. Pros, not interested in taking control on Monday. If you're going to buy this stock, you need to close above $4.30 on Monday to give us a buy signal for SunEdison. Of course, that upper trend line is going to continue to move lower daily if we do not see a buy signal on Monday. There's Bank of America. The air is getting pretty thin up here. We're up getting close to the summer highs. The easy money has been made. We took a run up to 1797 and then reversed. If we can take that out, then 1875 is our next target to the upside. We're on a buy signal right now, but we actually traded through the lower trend line twice last week. So it's a pretty weak buy signal with not a lot of upward momentum. And on Monday, we need to close below $17.38 to give us a new sell signal for Bank of America. Next up, we're moving north of the border and another broken stock, Bombardier. On the bullish side, we might have made a higher low here, and now what we're looking to see if we can make a higher high, and that would be to take out this high right here. And so that's what we're trying to do, trying to get over the 50-day moving average, then the 100, then potentially the 200-day moving average up there at the $2 level. If you look two lines up, 176, that's the trade, 195. That would be the extreme, and by the time we get to 195, of course, the 200-day moving average would be below the $2 level. On Monday, and we traded up to the upper channel line on Wednesday, traded through it on Thursday, traded up to it on Friday, have not closed above it yet, and so you can remain short this stock until we see a close above $1.34. That would give us a buy signal on Monday. Next up, we're looking at B2 Gold, and B2 Gold, we're down at the bottom of the panic zones. Pressure zone has formed, but it looks like it's starting to dissipate. And we're trying to hold support here at the 137 level. If that breaks, 117 is our next target to the downside, trying to break above the 50-day moving average. Recently got as high as the 200-day moving average in October, trying to run back up to that. The pros took control last week and then gave it up on Friday. And so that's unfortunate. We are still on a buy signal, have not closed below the lower channel line, drove down to it on Friday. The low on Friday was 140. We need to close below 139 on Monday to give us a sell signal for B2 Gold. And last up this morning, Tech Cominco. Tech is down at the bottom of the panic zones, currently ranked as zero. There's a pressure zone forming, very broken stock. We're trading below the flypaper channel, so any trade here is up to the flypaper channel, not above it. And we've had trouble getting over the 100-day moving average, so first we need the 50, then the 100, and if things really change, turn around for this market, then a move up to the 200-day moving average would be a huge percentage move for this stock if that were to happen. There we are in the middle between 469 and 625, so the next target to the downside is 469 if we don't get moving. Pros do not look like they have any interest in taking control of this stock at the moment. So on Monday, you can stay short until we see a close above $6.14. And of course, that upper trend line is going to continue to move lower daily. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation. Have a great day. And I'll be back again on Tuesday morning to take a look at the North American stock markets.